Hey, so I already started my hair and I was like, dang, I should have been, you know, recording, but my camera, I think I might have like 8 minutes on it. What I'm trying is flat twists. I never knew really, I won't say I didn't know how to flat twist. I was kind of scared that it won't come out right. I can braid, cornrow, everything, but for some reason, I couldn't flat twist right. So of all times, I decided to flat twist up, and it's going okay, actually. So I have four flat twists on the side, and then you can see the back. How I'm parting, I'm honestly just feeling, because you can kind of feel your hair, and you kind of feel where the part is at. And watch, just because I'm trying to show you, it's not going to come out straight, but I'm just kind of feeling for the part. And once I do that, I check and see if the part is straight and I flat twist up. So what I'll do, my mirror is in here. So I'm gonna go grab my mirror and I'll do one flat twist on camera. And then, excuse me, I'm gonna go back to just doing my hair, cause I don't really feel like trying to clear my camera to make space. So I'll come back and do one flat twist on camera. Okay, what you definitely want to do is, you see how my hair is kind of knotted, and not even knotted on the end, just because it was in some braids. I washed my hair last night, and I'm turning the camera a little bit. Washed my hair with the Tresemme Naturals, the low sulfates, pretty good. At first, I thought it was kind of ripping my hair, like moisture-wise, but then I realized, okay, no, it's pretty good. And then I followed up with the conditioner that goes with the shampoo. I did do Kimmy Too's leave-in, but I added grapeseed oil and vitamin E oil to the mixture, so it made it a little oilier. Well, actually, it's sitting right here. Can you kind of see that? I might be a little too close up to the camera. But like I said, it made it a little oily because I added some extra oils to it. And I have no problems with that. Like, I'm enjoying the leave-in. I was about to say something else. Oh, right now, what's on my hair, like I said, I did the leave-in last night, braided my hair down so I could stretch it. Remember, I got my hair straightened and she cut it in layers. So I feel like she cut, like, so much hair. I liked it, but I just feel like, man, maybe she took like 3-4 months of growth, but it's cool, you know, it's hair, grow back. So yeah, I'm using Eco Scholar Gel on the 2-strand twist. My Alma Heavy Cream, Comet Biologics. I'll put the correct name because I'm pretty sure I messed their name up. That and Pretty Dimple Shea Butter. So that's all I'm using right now. Lately I was making my own shea butter, but let me tell you, I was just so lazy, and I really like her shea butter. Like, it's really, really good. So I just was like, man, I'm just gonna buy some of hers. And that's sad, right? Really? Yeah, it's sad. I've been busy at work. So I already went and put a little Eco Styler gel on my hair, and you put a little here to make sure, you know, because this is what you have to grab. So kind of grab it, get ready for it, and I don't know if this is how, you know, the proper way, but it works for me, and hopefully you guys can see it. Okay, and you just kind of twist. I can't really explain it. You just kind of twist, and you try to hold it close to the scalp as possible because you want it to be as tight as possible. Kind of pick a piece of hair up. One hand needs to hold it and grab it. One hand needs to hold it, then grab a new piece. And the importance of not having tangles in your hair is because as you move up to try to deal with a tangle and grab, oh, no fun. So, and I think I'm supposed to do it a little closer together, you know, but I'm just kind of, because I'm using rubber bands at the end, I'm not really, you know, I want it tight, but I'm not as concerned with tightness, if I'm doing it right or not. But I think if you're trying to do it without the rubber bands, you may want to not go up as fast as I'm going. I mean, if you twist fast, but what I mean is twist closer. The two strands that you pick up may need to be closer. And I'm sorry, I'm talking to the back of me, talk from the back. Hold on. Okay. So after I do that, then I just take this. See if you can see. And just twist. And my plan is just to do two strand twists in the front. Because I started to two strand twist my entire hair. And some mini two strand twists. And I was just like, man, I'm tired. And I really want to go to the mall. Yeah, I'm tired, but I want to go to the mall. So I need to do my hair. Because I'm supposed to be going out with some friends tonight. So, got to do my hair now. So, that's the twist. And, like I said, I didn't bring my... You just want to put it aside. Don't yank your hair like I'm yanking. So, that's that. And I'll come back and at least show you the finished product. Like I said, I'm not going to record the entire thing. So, hopefully that helps someone. I don't know. But, thanks for watching. Okay, this isn't the final product yet, but I was like, I think everybody pretty much knows how to two-strand twist, but just in case, I said I'd do it. You just, I did a part, just kind of, I'm just parting it just like that. If you see, you can kind of see. I'm just doing parts and doing them in sections. I finished the back, and I'm going to probably pin the top down to make it, you know, a little neater. But all I do is parting section. I put equal style of gel on the section. Not a lot, but enough to kind of saturate the hair. You can kind of judge by how much you need by your own hair. Then I just pull a piece apart. Kind of make sure it's straight. Alright. And you just twist. And try to twist as tight as you can when you start it. So, you know, you don't want it. It's going to unravel, but when it unravels, you don't want it to completely unravel and be real loose, but it's going to unravel. And then because you're using gel and has water, your hair is usually going to, well, at least with my hair is going to draw up a lot too. So I'm already prepared for that. And like I said, I definitely feel like, I don't know when next time I'm going to straighten my hair. I don't know if I... Cutting the layers was a good idea, but I mean, it was good to get the frizz ends away. Cause if you can see, and you see this, let's see, that's a layer. You see that's a layer, and then these were layers here. So I guess my biggest thing is when I finish, I hope the layers doesn't look funny in the twist, you know. So anyway, just wanted to come on and show that. I've been doing my hair for about 2 hours and 10 minutes, so it's not too bad, and I think I should be finished in the next 10 to 15 minutes, so right on schedule. So I'll truly be back with the finished product this time. Thanks. All right, just finished my hair, and it's still a little wet, so I'll come back, not wet, but you know, it still has to kind of do its drawing up. So I'll show you, you know, how that looks in a few hours. It took me exactly 2 hours. So this is the front, the side, the flat twist, the back.